a method is something, some piece of code that basically can be called somewhere else. So as you can see in this example, instead of having like a repetitive piece of code that does something, so let's just write a simple method in IntelliJ, and then you will see what that's all about. Basically, as you can see, this is a method. Our main method, it's a special kind of method. It can be run. Other methods are look pretty much the same, but they cannot be run. This is our entry point to the our program. But other methods can be written in a similar way. So let's create some method: public, static, void. We will explain each of these words by itself relatively soon. But for now, let's just ignore them, and we can name our method anything. Basically, we can name a method whatever we want to name it. And now inside of that method, we can write the code similar to what we would be writing in main, but this will not be executed unless it's called in main. So let's now just print out something here. Hello from method anything. And now if we just write something here like hello from main, if we run this now, we will just see hello from main. As you can see here, this is even grayed out. It's saying is never used. You wrote something that's never used. The thing is, the only bit of code that's run is the one that in between these curlies inside of the main method. But we can have as many methods as we want. We can have like 10 methods here. And for example, now we can call this method by just typing the name of it. Now we've called this method here. Basically, as you can see, system out print line is also some sort of a method. It's just not called only with its name, it's called with something else. This is like basically system.out is some variable from the system, right? We want to print out there. But we can have our methods inside of this class, or we can even call methods from the other class. We will see that as well. But for now, let's just run this, see what happens. Okay, now we have actually wrote the method and we've also called it. We can call it as many times as we want. We can call it multiple times and it'll just, you know, get called every time. The method can contain, you know, multiple lines. It can be any number of lines that you want. I mean, this is basically not really doing anything, but if we call this now, it'll print out a bunch of times. So why would this be useful? So let's just go back to the previous week when we were doing arrays. Well, basically we've used here like this was printing out of minimum and maximum, but let's say we wanted to print out all the numbers from an array. Let's just create some array here. I'll get rid of this useless method that was just for show. And let's say we have a couple of arrays. So let's say int array A1 equals, I don't know, something 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever. And let's just assume we have a couple of arrays that we want to print out. How would we do that? Well, we can do it by saying, you know, for loop array 1.length and so on and so on, and printing out all the elements. A1 of I, but then we would have to literally do the same thing for A2, you know, change A2 here, change to A2 and so on. Well, I'm just gonna go ahead and change the numbers so they're different. Let's have A2 have all the negative ones, and let's have this one have like three digit ones. Okay, so you can already see that this kind of looks bad because we have literally three blocks of code that they're doing literally the same thing. So we can create a method for printing out our array. I mean, and all of this code would be just reduced to a much less lines of code. And also it's much more reusable. So for example, let's create a method. And as we can see here in the slides, the methods can have no parameters. That's like this method or the anything method that I wrote. I'm just gonna leave it public static void something, you know. This is a method without parameters. So that one does, I mean, it's not smart. It doesn't do anything. It just always does the same thing. Hello from something. We're not going to use this one. I just wanted to write it just so it's there. And the best thing about this is we can leave it here. We can even contract it. It doesn't really, you know, bother us at all. It's just there. Now we can create methods with parameters as well. Let's say public static void. Let's create a simpler one. And then we will move on to the array example because I might have jumped too fast there. So let's create a method that just sums two numbers. It takes two parameters, int A and int B, And it basically just prints out the sum. So let's say S out A plus B. This is an example of a really simple method that has two parameters. As you can see inside of brackets here, there's nothing, but we still have to provide the brackets just to tell Java this is a method, you know. And here inside of these regular brackets, we can have as many methods as we want, as many parameters as we want, and they can be of the type that we need, right? So this method will just sum. For now, I'll just ignore this. I wanted to comment it out and contract it. We'll get back to that example a little bit later because this one is way simpler to explain the parameters. So now when we call sum, you can see here that Java is offering us this. Yeah, that's exactly what we want. And now it's complaining here because it's saying you need to, you know, provide some parameters. You cannot just call sum without parameters because here it said it'll have two parameters and they will both be of type int. So if I try to pass like 5 and 6, that'll work. If I say int A equals 20, and if I now pass A here, it'll also work. If I try to pass a double, it'll complain. It'll say, hey, you're trying to pass a double, require type int, and you're providing a double. So it'll complain. So be careful of that because the methods, the parameters need to be provided exactly in the same order and in the same type that they're given. One thing that would work, for example, double A and double B, now it doesn't complain if we try to pass 5 here. Why? Well, because it's like 5.0. It can always convert implicitly from integer to double without losing any data, but it cannot do it the other way. You know, it cannot convert 6.3 to 6 without losing data, you know. So this, now it's not complaining when we pass an integer and a double, you know, because double is a wider type, you know, it can implicitly convert from an integer to a double, so it doesn't complain here. But if we try to pass a string here, it's again complaining, it's saying, hey, you need to provide a double, you provide a string. So when calling a method, be careful to always pass the parameters in the proper order, you know. For example, let's just create another method just to showcase something. I'll just duplicate this and I will call this method example, doesn't really matter. And I want to pass a string, and these parameter names can be anything that you want. It can be like my name or whatever, you know, the parameters, you choose the name for parameters, right? You choose the names that you want. So now when calling example, I cannot say 5.5 and then something. It must be the other way around because the first parameter needs to be a string, the second one needs to be a double, so I have to switch it up for it to properly work, right? So this works, right? So that's how parameters work in Java. Okay, so of course it can have like any number of parameters. We can add an integer here, int something. And now it's complaining here because it's missing that parameter. So let's add that. That's a 9. And we can add a Boolean. You know, we can have as many parameters. We can add another int, like int else. It cannot be named else because that's a keyword, you know, something else. You know, we can have as many parameters as we need, and they can be of any types that we need, right? Okay. And this method doesn't really do anything, but I just wanted to show you a couple of different parameters. Okay, so let's go back to our sum. Let's see if it works. Let's just, we've called sum and we've called example, but example is not really doing anything, so that'll not print out anything. So now we have this hello from main that's remained here, and now we've called example. It went ahead and printed out the sum of these two numbers, and it's 5 plus 6.3, so that's 11.3. Okay, so if we put a breakpoint like somewhere around here, you can see when we debug that it first hits this breakpoint, right? It stopped here. So when I click play, it goes here, right? Because it called the sum method. So it goes inside of it, does all the lines of the sum method, then goes back to the next line in the main method, right? Okay. So now let's change this up a little bit. Let's play around with it a little. Let's just say S out hello from example method. And here I'm going to say S out hello from sum. And now of course, you can call a method from another method. So for example, if inside of sum, I wanted to call example, I can do that. I just need to pass some parameters. I can pass an empty string, a double, an integer, and an integer. Okay. So now if we try to follow up what's going on, let's first run it without the debugging and let's see what's happened. So first we have hello from main, that's executed this line. Then it's called sum. So now it says hello from sum, which is this line. Now it says the sum of these two numbers, and it called example. And this is hello from example method once, and then it goes back here, right? And then it calls example from main as well. So these are two hello from example. It's called example twice. Since the program read from top to bottom, how does computer know the method is being called? Well, basically it comes here and it says, okay, sum is called, go there, you know, execute everything from sum and then go back to where you were, right? And it can, you know, of course, it can go into another method like this example. An example can call something, you know. So now it just there would be a mistake if we try to call like sum here, because that would be an infinite loop, you know. It would probably even complain or not. I think it would crash. It would just crash. Yeah. The thing is, it's called. You can see here, it did a bunch of calls, and it even printed out stuff. But then it just crashed because there's too many calls, right? Because sum is calling example, example is calling sum, and it's a never-ending story. They're just like calling each other until my computer decides to kill them because it causes a Stack Overflow or something. Let's see the beginning of the error. I would say no, it just died for some. Yeah, it's a Stack Overflow error. That means you've seen of the site Stack Overflow. That's the main site for programming questions, and it's called after this error. You know, that happens when you have too many things on the stack. Basically, what it's doing here is you've seen it. It's sum is calling example, and example is calling sum. And inside of that sum, we're calling example. And inside of that example, we're calling sum again, and it just keeps on forever until it crashes, you know, because it eats up too much RAM memory, and then the system kills it. Like, what have you been doing? You know, so of course we cannot do that. We shouldn't do that, you know, but of course inside of sum, we can call example method, and inside of example, we can call something and so on, you know. And here a nice difference is if I just write something without anything, it refers to the variable and it's saying, well, this is not a statement. You just said the name of a variable. If I add the braces, then it becomes a method and it works. So now if you run this, let's just check out what's calling what. So again, we go through main. This is the first line that prints out. Then it calls sum, and this one is waiting still until we come back from the sum method. So now inside of sum, we have hello from sum, which is the second line of our output. The third line is the sum that it printed out. Of course, this method shouldn't be called sum because it's doing way much more than the sum, but it's just for example purposes. Then it says call example. So now we're basically in example method. So it says hello from example method. And then it calls something. Example calls something. So it now calls this. It says hello from something. And what do we do now? Well, we've finished example, so we come back to whoever called it. This one called it, and we've now, upon executing this, we finished the sum as well. So we go back to whoever called that. So that's this one, right? And once we're done with that, we can now move on to the next line, which is example. Well, example again prints out hello from example, but it's still not done. It needs to call something as well. So now this one gets called again and prints out this. And after that, finally, we are done with example method, and we are done with the code because there's no more code after this.